This week on the Mr. Throwback Thursday podcast, we bring you a trip to 88 with the Prince. Even Hove doesn't want to have lunch with Hove. Ms. Lauryn Hill telling Philly she's going to be late. One of the strangest Halloween treats ever. And Blair Underwood as Billy Bootyhole Brown. Brown. What else? Let's listen.
It's not just any day. It's Mr. Throwback Thursday.
All these kids want to get on and shit.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Help, I'll be dead.
At the count of three, I want y'all to tell me the name of my DJ. One, two, three.
Poppers, poppin', the breakers break. All the fellas say ho, and the girls say hey. Give it up for the DJ, Mr. Throwback Thursday.
And now, here's your hosts, Bill Winters. And Mr. Throwback Thursday himself, Jamie Robinson.
And a pleasant, happy Throwback Thursday to everybody. Welcome to Mr. Throwback Thursday. This is episode 509 with your two favorite hosts, Minister Jamie and Billy Bootyhole Brown.
Billy Bootyhole Brown.
Thank you, Cool Kim, for that last week. I'm never going to live that down. That has now been immortalized on our Facebook page and on our MrThrowbackThursday.com page.
Thank you to Pumice for that.
But big thanks to Cool Kim for coming on last week. He was so much fun. We've had other interviews that I've enjoyed immensely, but I don't think I've talked about them as much during the following week as I did this one. And, you know, in the video he put up of him unboxing his gift.
Yes.
that was even better. Yeah, so
if for some reason you guys haven't seen that, you know, go check out Cool Kim on any social media. And I believe on Instagram, I am a collaborator on his reel. So you could find it if you go to Reels.
Yeah.
Under mine.
It was hysterical. It really was. This week, we're back to our normal menu of items.
Normal.
We have hip hop headlines. We have some woo news. We'll get to the music that we didn't get to last week. We'll remind you who the artist of the month is for. Actually, by this time, we have a new artist of the month.
Oh, yeah.
Would you be so kind, my friend, to get us started with a little bit of Triple H?
Yay.
And? Get that hashtag in there.
Yes, cookies.
This is Hip Hop Headlines, brought to you by Mr. Throwback Thursday.
We'll get on it. It's your toin.
It is my toin, and my toin will start with not a friend of the show, but a person we admire, and a person who always has really good opinions on things, and that is $2 Hort.
Yes, he was a big, gigantic Oakland, you know, Bay Area. I represent it. But he knows hip hop started in the East, and he doesn't try
to deny that.
Yeah, he doesn't say, no, you're forgetting about the West. No, he's all in on how history actually happened.
And we're talking about the people who are pissing and moaning in the past about not being included in these 50th anniversary celebrations. Short took a different angle on it. And I think a little controversial, I'm sure, within the hip hop community amongst the artists.
Probably.
But I'm not 100% sure he doesn't have a point.
No, I'm with you.
Short came right out and said, you know, 50th anniversary of hip hop. I think that what happened was supposed to happen, he said. Grandmaster Caz and his peers from before Rapper's Delight were supposed to spearhead the movement and say that something that they started 50 years has grown, and they're the founders and forefathers. Short says, too much attention was given to the next generation of artists after that.
Mm-hmm.
Because they haven't been around for 50 years.
No, and he's not talking about like Lil Baby and Sexy. He's not talking about those people.
No, he's talking about people like Slick Rick.
Yeah.
And he name drops them. He's like, if you're going to throw in Slick Rick, Chuck D, Snoop Dogg, you're going to outshine the originals. I feel we should have celebrated the first 7 years before Rapper's Delight.
Mm-hmm.
And before Sylvia Robinson and Sugar Hill Records took the torch, which was a beautiful thing, he says. The other side is, did we really celebrate the history of hip hop in Chicago, Miami, Houston, Oakland, and L.A.? Everyone wasn't celebrating 50. I was celebrating 43.
Yeah.
I feel that we missed the mark by not just singling out the first generation. The rest of us could have just said that we carried the torch.
Right. So he is one who agrees, as we've said here and have had guests say here, this is 50 years of New York hip hop.
Right.
Short gets that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's cool that you guys are celebrating 50 over there. I'm celebrating 43 years here myself.
Mm-hmm. So when other people see, Short's always been deferential to those who came before him. He gets
yes.
it. But I'm sure that didn't go over well with a lot of his peers.
Yeah.
But I also picture Mr. Shaw to be one of those people who, if you disagree with him, he'll probably say, "Motherfuck you, damn shithead indeed. Bitch.
Yeah, who are you? I'm too short.
I'm a mic." But he's not Billy Booty Hole Brown.
Who so. Is, though?
Apparently me. Thanks, Kim.
I have heard that about you.
Billy Booty Hole Brown.
Forever.
Yeah. Just add it to the list.
Yep.
So our next article, Ladies First.
Ooh, Ladies First.
Now, we mentioned that Will Smith started this new show, right? This new podcast. We talked about it maybe about a month ago. Mm-hmm. I think Class of 88 podcast.
Yes.
With Will, and I think Jeff is on it too. He had Queen Latifah on.
He did.
I'm going to have to start putting this into my podcast library because I have not
now listened that it's begun, to it yet. Yeah,
now
I haven't
that it,
either.
Yeah, now that it's a thing, I might have to, especially now that he's had the Queen.
Well, yes. You
know, or was she Dana that day? I don't know.
You never
I
know. We'll have to yet. Listen to find out.
But Will sat down with Dana Owens, mm-hmm. professionally known as Queen Latifah, to talk about Ladies First, which came out in 1988.
It did. A number.
Smith actually said, and you know, with everything that Will is going through with this whole nonsense with his ridiculous wife, for him to be able to concentrate on this and actually put out a decent product, from what I understand,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna give him full marks on this. He had Latifah on. He acknowledged to her that putting out a record, Ladies First, at the time, was kind of hardcore, he says, because hip hop was pretty male dominated.
It was.
He says, it seems obvious, but that was revolutionary, he said. And, you know, Latifah is like,
but this time around.
Yeah. She says, I had to.
The revolution will not be televised.
So she started talking to him about, you know, how she had to establish herself in the business. She said, how am I going to make myself different from my heroes? Light, Salt and Pepper, Sweet Tea. There's a name that doesn't get mentioned enough. Sweet Tea.
Yeah.
How am I going to do this? She said, I need to carve a path that's different. Maybe not so far, but it has to be different. So that was the goal. And then she came up with the title as a way of bridging a gap. She goes, a lot of it was, why am I beefing with these girls? Why do these girls keep beefing with each other? We could do a lot more if we stood together, i.e. Ladies First. Why don't I just embrace you and maybe you'll embrace me and let me encourage you? Mm-hmm. So, you know, which I think is a cool idea, you know, and she says, I had to carve a path that's different from them. And then we saw some of the other different paths that have been carved.
Yes.
By Lil Kim and Foxy Brown back then, and which then became, you know, Sexy Red and her booty hole brown.
Billy Booty Hole Brown.
But there wouldn't be a Billy Booty Hole Brown if there wasn't for a Foxy Brown or a Lil Kim. So, again, Latifah always spits knowledge, man. She really does. So I'm going to have to add this to my library and give Will a listen, because I do a lot of driving. I'll probably do that tonight, because I do have to drive to Newburgh again.
Mm-hmm.
And that 45 minutes goes a lot quicker when you're listening to something that, you know, instead of the same things over and over and over.
Instead of listening to us.
Well, I've listened to us on the trip too. I listened to the Cool Kim episode twice this week just for the sheer self-loathing torture. I don't know. Maybe I need therapy.
Yeah, who knows?
So
you sound like a very assertive woman, but we're not going to go there.
Apparently so. We haven't had enough Will Smith news yet.
So
we're going to go a little bit more Will Smith.
Let's do that.
We're going to have two doses of the Prince. Hot New Hip Hop brings us this one, and you have titled this one Prince and Peppa.
Yes.
Will Smith was afraid of going on a date with Peppa because of Tretch.
Yes. Well, and that's a very good reason to be afraid.
Peppa was on a break from Tretch at the time. He had a one-off date with Sandy Denton, known as Peppa. He says, I think you and Tretch had been broke up for a minute. So in my mind, when I was like trying to spit my game, but I ain't really have nothing, because my concern was I was going to get killed. He said
that is a very serious concern. Yo, Tretch was a menacing. I mean, Tretch still is a menacing looking figure.
Still a menacing looking dude.
Yeah.
And just listening to how sharp his tongue is, you get the feeling this is a guy that is not fuckwithable.
Yes.
Or unfuckwithable. Indeed, I don't know what the exact word is, but, and then Tretch got back at him.
I love this part.
With this laughing emoji, just teasing him, of course.
Yes.
Because apparently they're good. But Tretch saw the clip online and he said to him, he goes, "Keep my name concerning my ex bitch out your fucking mouth." He
said. Well played, Tretch.
And, Peppa actually said to Will, it was a legitimate concern.
Yeah, you should have been afraid.
And she had a nice time with him. She said, "You were very nice. This was the date you won and beat us out. You were so happy." He was like, "Let's go celebrate. We were out. You saw a homeless person. You gave the homeless person $100. Then we went to the Hollywood sign." So Will Smith is, he's a much better dude than what he's getting nonsense for. And I have a feeling if a certain individual was not in his life, he probably wouldn't have nearly the drama that he does.
I would almost have to say that guarantee.
She cultivates more shit for him. And if I was him, I honestly don't know if I could take it at this point.
As gracefully as he does.
I would probably have lashed out at this point and been like, "Will you shut the fuck up?" Yeah,
but then he's the bad guy.
You know what? I don't think at this point anybody would consider him the bad guy anymore.
Yeah.
Because I think even the general public is like, "Okay, enough."
Jada, you know? Please stop talking.
you not everything needs to be shared.
Mm-hmm. She's got a whole book about it. Want to read it?
Here it goes. What would you rather have? Let's ask this question. You've called this "Give Me the Loot." Q104, Audacy.com/Q104.
This is everywhere. This has been a thing for a few years now, but this is just who I grabbed it from.
So would you rather have $500,000 cash?
Yes.
Or have lunch with not just a businessman, but a businessman, one Hawaiian Sophie who we have stated may be the best businessman in hip hop.
Yes. But I'm going to tell you what any good businessman should tell you.
Take the loot.
Give me the loot. Give me the loot.
give me the loot. And I can turn that loot into more loot.
Yes.
I mean, you have lunch with somebody. What are you doing? You're turning food into poo.
Yeah. And he says it in this article or in this interview. I didn't hear the Gayle King interview, but he says, I would also take the money and then tell you, go listen to all my albums, mm-hmm. buy some music and listen. I tell you everything that you need to know in those lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to impart to you any super wisdom while we're sitting there eating a meal together.
Right.
You know, and that makes sense. You know, like, do you get to have a one-on-one business meeting with him, you know, for a couple hours or something? That's very different than sharing a meal with somebody in a restaurant at your home, mm-hmm. anything. You're not going to be deep in conversation while you have food in front of you, you know?
Although I have been in diners and places like this where people have completely deep, inappropriate conversations over food. And you're sitting there going, well, I don't want this chicken parm anymore. Now that I know that
those are very different conversations.
Now that I know that this one bleaches their booty hole. So it's no longer booty hole brown.
Billy booty hole brown.
And that's an actual conversation that happened at dinner. One
I have
time.
Zero doubt. But those type of conversations are okay.
A family acquaintance actually pulled up on their phone a chart of different color levels of anal bleaching while we were at the time was the Hyde Park Brewery.
Mm-hmm.
So while I'm sitting there looking down at my chicken parm, I'm discussing what shade would you like your anus bleached to?
Well, that is a good question, though. You know, you got to pick a color.
Otherwise, you're going to end up with
Billy Booty O'Brien.
Look, I might as well just feed into this thing.
You
I know
may
you're
as
gonna,
well at this point.
You're going to hit it 17 times in the show anyway. I might as well find reasons for it.
And when you get the T-shirt for Christmas, I expect to see it.
If I get a T-shirt for Christmas that says this, I will wear it on the very first episode of the new year.
Okay, how's that's that? Fair.
So, yeah. Jay-Z, have you seen my poop swatches? Shit swatch.
That's maybe not what that's the Fat Boys were wearing.
Maybe that's my new hip hop name. Shit swatch. Is that anything like Sasquatch?
Who knows?
Or as Patton Oswalt would say, look, honey, there goes fuck squatch. So Jay-Z would rather have $500,000 than lunch with himself.
As would I.
As would I, yeah. Gayle King is just like, he's talking to me.
Oprah made him talk to me.
I was going
to
say, has anybody done more with the fact that they're friends with somebody? You constantly hear people talking about nepotism being bad.
Mm-hmm.
What is it when it's not family, when it's just friends? Is it still nepotism?
I would say so.
Because that's what it is with Dr. Phil. I'm glad you mentioned him. I had completely forgotten about him.
Yeah, it's easy to do. Dr. Oz.
Well, not so easy to do when you talk like a bumbling idiot.
Mm-hmm.
And I talk like a bumbling idiot.
Catch me outside, yeah.
Oh, good Lord. Yes, thanks. Thank you for setting Bahad Behaby out on us. Fuck you. I can't. And she needs to go away too.
Yeah.
No, nobody's seen your poop swatches, John. That's how we get back to this. So,
Dr. Phil is just Mr. Mackey.
He kind of is. Now that you say that,
he's Mr. Mackey with a different accent.
I just, I used to say when I was talking about my kids, I said, my goal as a parent is not to end up as a surprise guest on Dr. Phil, having that bald fucker go, "You need to look in the mirror and recognize your behaviors."
Okay.
Okay. Drugs are bad. Shouldn't do drugs. Next article.
Yes.
And Blair Underwood as.
This is the only thing I don't like about doing our show weekly is we record on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. We release on a Thursday. And news happens in between that you're like, oh, I wish we could have talked about that, but now it's too late.
Yeah.
But some important dates, although oddball numbers, some important dates, I have to go back and mention things that happened.
Yes.
So it's not like, necessarily on this day. It's previously on, you know, yes. While you were out.
And last week in 1985,
a number,
Russell Simmons, along with Michael Schultz,
not distributed. Charles Schultz.
No, that would be a different movie altogether. It would. Distributed Crush Groove.
Yes.
Which I still think is the greatest Fresh Flicks we have done.
It was a good one.
Just because.
It was no tougher than leather, but you know.
On the fractured butthole. How can you fracture? I just.
No, it's the fractured butthole.
Yes. Yes. Context, syntax,
yes.
And emphasis on the right syllables. Indeed. Makes all the difference in the world. So 38 years ago, Crush Groove was released. 38 is not normally an anniversary that we would acknowledge. It's usually one where they come out. It's like, why? Why are we celebrating 38?
Because these people are still alive.
Yeah, which at this point is saying something because we're losing people left and right.
Well, 2/3 of the Disco 3 that were in that movie.
Yeah.
JMJ.
The Disco 3, Fat Boys, Run DMC, JMJ. Yep. He's going. Curtis Blow, who I'm shocked is still here with his health issues, to be honest with you. Jekyll and Hyde.
We lost half of Jekyll and Hyde. Andre Harrell.
We lost 1/3 of the Beasties.
Yeah.
And Sheila E's still around.
Yes, she is.
She's on a new game show, I think, isn't she?
I have no idea. She
Loteria Loca on CBS?
Maybe. I did see her. Yes.
That's an odd thing for her to do, but you know
she's
what?
Like the house musician. She's the band leader.
She's getting paid. That's all that matters. Get what do the kids say now? I'm trying to sound hip. Hello, fellow teenagers.
Yes. Give me the loot. Give me the loot.
Oh. Get that bag, girl. But yeah, give me the loot. Give me the loot. And still one of the greatest soundtracks ever.
Yes.
With All You Can Eat and I Can't Live Without My Radio.
Box.
The original If I Ruled the World.
Mm-hmm.
Not the Nas and Lauryn Hill version. We're talking Mr. Curtis Blow.
And
the
first appearance of Chris Rock.
Mm-hmm. And the Crush Groove All-Stars with Crush Grooving, Body Moving.
Body Moving.
I had that might be the first repeat Fresh Flicks we do. Russell Simmons was in it, not playing Russell Simmons.
That is the greatest part of that whole movie. Everyone plays themselves. Everyone.
Except Russell Simmons is played by, I need somebody to play me, but it's got to be more debonair.
Let me see who reminds me of me.
But it's better looking. Blair Underwood. No, Body Rock will not happen again.
Look, any movie that we had to watch as a Fresh Flicks on YouTube because no one else in the world had it.
That would be like if we had again to watch Deathbed.
No, I still own that.
Yeah, well, you and the guy who wrote it.
And that's Pat Oswalt.
I don't even know if he owns it.
I know he saw it.
Yes. So stop me if you've heard this one. Hey, Philly, I'm going to be late. This is a little different,
though. It is, yes.
This was actually, I got a doctor's note.
Why are you late? I got a doctor's note.
Look, I mean, look, if you miss work, you're supposed to have a doctor's note.
But you shouldn't have one in advance. Like, okay, next week I'm gonna be out because I'm gonna be sick. But I'll have a doctor's note.
Unless you have some kind of chronic thing that says, you know, this person, because I've written these kind of notes for people. Yeah, maybe that's what it is. He had
some sort of chronic thing and that was it.
Oh, well done. I've written notes for people who have chronic conditions that say there are times this patient is going to need time off. And if they say they need time off because of this debilitating condition, if you have questions, call us, but don't fuck with them. Give them time off.
Yes.
We stated a little bit more eloquently than that, but that's basically what it is. It's like, look, we're saying this person's sick and it happens from time to time. And unless you want to get sued, give them the time off they need.
But it just reminds me of this video that I'm going to put up on the screen and see if I screw everything else up while doing it. Hold on.
Oh, okay, kid. Be seated.
Yes, Kenny. What is it?
It's going to fuck up. Yes. Anyways.
Please excuse me for being late. I have explosive diarrhea.
Kenny had a doctor's note, man.
Kenny had a doctor's note. It wasn't a doctor's note. He had his own note that says what he's got, and he signed it K. I would just send him right out of the class. So Lauryn Hill was supposed to perform in Philadelphia.
Yes.
She is notorious for using the clock as a guideline as opposed to an actual thing. Let's put it that way. It's kind of like the Pirate's Code. You know, stick to the code is really just a sense of guidelines, more or less. Yes. And you're not a pirate anyway, so it doesn't apply. Oh, I got to watch that movie again. I love those movies. she was scheduled to play a show in Philadelphia recently and announced on social media that it was delayed. It is with disappointment that I am writing this note to you. Signed, Epstein's mother.
Yes.
On the advice of my physicians, I have no choice but to postpone the show tomorrow. I need to rest my voice to prevent any more serious strain or damage to my vocal cords. I guess that's a legitimate excuse when you are a performer who uses your voice to perform.
Yes. And
that being said, someone
who sings.
That being said, you probably should work on not scheduling so many shows back to back to back to back.
Yes. When you are, let's just say, out of practice.
It's not difficult to say, look, I can do two shows in a row. I'm going to need 2 days in between. Right. Plus, that gives you time to travel and get set up if you're doing all these other.
And transport pros across state lines. And
I have never understood how, you know, it's like, hey, this band is in New York City on Tuesday, and then they're in Pensacola, Florida on Wednesday.
Yeah.
How the fuck did they get there?
In an airplane.
How the fuck did the sets get there unless they have multiple sets?
Or they have people who just drive through the night.
That's dangerous, man.
It is. Ask Tracy Morgan.
Oh, no. Don't ask Tracy Morgan anything about driving. Brother's got a bad reputation for that. So, again, she says, I need to rest my vocal cords. She expresses how enjoyable the tour has been up to this point. She will be back next month, November 25th. So the full statement is listed and it's on her Instagram page. Oh, God. It is with disappointment that I'm writing this note to you on the advice of my physicians. I have no choice but to postpone the show tomorrow. I need to rest my voice. The start of this tour has been incredible. What an amazing experience to celebrate this anniversary with all of my family, my friends, and all of you. This is the same woman that said, I'd rather have my kids starve than have white people buy my music. Yep. Maybe she's changed.
Maybe.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Indeed.
I look forward to giving you the show you deserve with a fully recovered and healthy voice. Parentheses. It's just going to start 4 hours late.
As long as you know this.
The new date for Philadelphia will be November 25th. Parentheses. I will be taking the stage on the 27th.
Yes. Again, if you know this.
Yeah. I mean, again, it's like what we said. How many times are you going to touch the stove and burn your hand before you realize it's hot? So a little eastbound and down from John. John's on fire today. Who gives a. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
That's our next one. The New York Daily News brings us this one. And I didn't send you this.
You did not. I do my own work sometimes, man.
Yeah, but usually anything from the Daily News or the New York Post, because those are the two periodicals that I read on a regular basis. The Grammys salute to 50 years of hip hop special. So apparently somebody gives a fuck about a goddamn
somebody
Grammy.
Somebody does, yes.
Or Grammy gives a fuck about hip hop.
Yeah. But here's a question. Didn't Questlove already do this?
He did.
Okay.
He did.
Do we get the Grammys twice in the same year?
Not usually.
So I'm confused about this part.
Unless it's just a special concert that Grammy is hitching their, you know, hitching their name
you
to.
You didn't like the one we did last time.
Mm-hmm. But this one is going to have Roxanne Shanté, Big Daddy Kane, and MC Light. They've joined the lineup of the upcoming Grammy Salute to 50 Years of Hip Hop, which is it's a special. It's a concert special. So it's a lot like, you know, when the other genres of music do this, like the American Country Music Awards celebrate so-and-so.
Right.
But this is the first time I've ever seen the Grammys do it.
Well, that's because we don't usually give a fuck about the goddamn Grammys.
This thing is going to be filmed November 8th at the YouTube Theater in Inglewood, California. Up to no good. The show is going to air December 10th on CBS and also stream on Paramount Plus. So that might be worth a watch.
I would say so.
So definitely for me, a big watch.
We'll give a fuck about the goddamn Grammys.
Jesse Collins Entertainment is the producer of this show. They're the brains behind the halftime show that had Dre and Snoop and all them in it.
And Batman.
Yes.
50 Cent.
It's a 2-hour special. It's going to showcase the profound history of hip hop and celebrate the genre's monumental cultural impact around the world, according to their official description, which, of course, sounds like it was written by a PR firm.
Right.
Previously announced performers for this show, which I didn't even know was a thing until you sent me this week. Latifah's going to be there. So we get two Latifah news in 1 week.
Unless she's on vacation.
And it's just Dana today. Yeah. LL Cool J. Rakim.
Speaking of LL Cool J, I want to interrupt here. Anybody know this guy?
That would be Cool J.
It is. I believe I'm going to take my Cool J and put him in an envelope like the original Flat Stanley.
Uh-huh.
And put a message with it so we can send it around the world. The same Cool J around the world, like Lisa Stansfield.
Mm-hmm.
And see what happens. Maybe we'll come up with a Facebook page just for Falalat Cool J, or
where in the world is Falalat Cool J,
or an Instagram. I don't know how we would do that. We would have to come up with a Falalat Cool J Instagram account and just have people tag Falalat Cool J on the gram and see where it goes. That way we can get him outside of the posse, because
And then Falalat Cool J can have his own Tiki Talkie.
Fucking hate Tiki Talkie. But anyway, but yeah, and we'll like put a sheet of paper in with him that has to go with him. And everybody can sign where he's been and
Right.
And we'll see what happens.
Like a log.
Yes. It's big. It's heavy. It's wood. Oh, wrong log.
Or somehow maybe get something online database where we give
digital
the
tracking
address to, you know, go online and put who you are, where you've been, and see if you can upload a picture of Cool J there too. I mean, that's something we could do.
Worst thing that happens, it leaves my house and it never comes back. Who knows?
And then we can print out another one.
We have the technology.
I think you should start by sending it to Cool Kim. Except he'll drop it on his bed.
But he won't break this one.
He won't break
this one. No chance of breakage.
He didn't break the mug. Thankfully. No, he didn't. He's like, yo, thank God I was on my bed. Well, other performers at this Grammy show, as we, you know,
are not full of that Cool J.
That are not full of that Cool J. Although, how cool would it be to send full of that Cool J to Cool J, and have him be on the stage?
See, I think that if we get this thing to actually go somewhere,
mm-hmm.
somehow we get it back. I don't know how we get it back.
After 50.
And then 50. Send it to the museum. So they can display cool. Full of Lat Cool J and everywhere he's been.
That would be cool. That would be full of Lat Cool.
let me talk to some peoples and see if we can absolutely. Arrange something.
And maybe turn it into a fundraiser.
Mm.
You know, help support full of Lat Cool J getting to the hip hop museum.
Yes.
So anyway,
yes.
Non full of Lat Cool J, no. Swole Cool J will be on this special
with a K
as well as Rakim. The supersonic trio of JJ Fad, the luminary icon, friend of the show, MC Sha Rock.
Yes.
The Far Side, my good friend Billy, Uncle Luke, friend of the show, Yo Yo.
Mm-hmm.
And who gives a fuck about a goddamn Emmy, Grammy, and Oscar winning lyricist, Common.
Yes.
Also on board for the event, Arrested Development, Black Sheep, Cypress Hill, Diggable Planets. We have friends in pretty much all of these groups, by the way, which is ridiculous for us to say, even 10 years almost into this.
Word on the street is that Drez and Mr. Long may be getting back together. I've seen pictures of the two of them together.
Mm-hmm.
Ronnie has a good idea for Flo the Lat Cool J.
Mm-hmm. That's why I said 50 years of hip hop. We should get 50 signatures.
Yeah. And then have it come back. And yeah. And we'll put the tag full of Lat Cool J.
Mm-hmm. Send it to your friends in the hip hop community.
Yeah.
And then the last one, and then we'll send it to LL.
Yes.
He should be the last one.
Well, I would think since we're going to be doing season two, if we can get it around the world tonight. Yeah. Yeah. And then, get it back. I can get it to Pete.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Pete can give it to LL when they're doing an episode of the show or something.
Then have the 49th person
send it to Pete.
Send it to us or send it to Pete and have Cool be the LL Cool J be the 50th signature.
Let me see what we can do.
Let me write this down. Ronnie, I like your idea, buddy. This is why we have smart friends. Jay. Yes. It's a good thing the posse's smart because the hosts are idiots.
Yes. Make sure you put a hashtag cookies.
Yes. Hashtag cookies get you into the drawing for later today to get Daryl Makes Cookies. They are the coolest cookies in the universe. Because it says right on a
fresh radio sticker too.
Cool. Other people on this show, word to the motherfucking DJ Quick.
Yes.
E-Fody, Glorilla, Gunna, Jeezy, Juvenile, Lotto.
Formerly Miss Mulatto from,
mm-hmm.
What the heck was that? Jermaine Dupri games, the rap game.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, a little poopy.
Loonies, who have their own level on our Patreon.
Yes, they have five on it.
DJ Spinderella, the 3-6 Mafia, T.I., $2 Hort, second time he's been mentioned today. 2 Chainz. The Regulator himself, the greatest song in the history of hip hop, Warren G and YG are also on board for the event. So this is going to be a pretty cool thing. And what I say, December 10th is when it's supposed to be.
I think so.
Broadcast. Yes. September 10th on CBS and Paramount Plus. So if you can't watch it live, make sure your DVR is set.
On Memorex.
Oh. On Memorex. The last article. And I hate you, by the way, for this.
I didn't do this.
No, but you're putting this out in the universe. Well,
everyone's going to hate me because I'm going to play it. Well, it's out in the
universe, but you're sharing it.
Yes.
Here comes Halloween. This comes to us from Yahoo.com.
Yes.
They don't even use that anymore. Why do we matter. Do that?
We do. Because we are a throwback show.
Okay.
We throw back to previous advertising.
Where's the beef?
Indeed.
Between Wendy's buns.
Of course.
That was the old joke. Yahoo Entertainment answers the question that everybody has on their lips. Why did child star advocate Corey Feldman agree to record a Halloween song with the 4-year-old son of Flavor Flav?
The world may never know.
Because he says, I was just amazed at his energy and his talent. He says, I'm not a real big fan or supporter of kids in the industry. I think everybody knows that. So I don't really like to push a child working agenda. But JRD is the name.
Yeah, I believe his him and Kate's son is Jordan.
Mm-hmm. Is Jordan Drayton, a.k.a. 4-year-old viral singer JRD. He needed a duet partner. Corey Feldman did for his spooky single Here Comes Halloween.
Look, do you know the last time Corey Feldman did a rap song? You know who his duet partner was?
I'm afraid to ask because no, I don't.
The Mike Stalker.
Wow.
Doc Ice.
That's surprising.
Oh my Lord. It was horrible. It was on some morning show. I don't know if it was Good Morning America or one of them. Somebody... find it, research department. I know you've seen it. It was the you know when you feel bad for someone?
Yeah, when you're watching something you're and you're embarrassed, like,
for them.
Yes. I you know when I felt that most recently?
Right before the show when I showed you that video.
No. And you know, this probably is going to be a terrible thing for me to admit. The last time I saw Dick Clark hosting the New Year's Eve thing.
Mm-hmm. Where they wheeled him out.
I was like, why are they doing this to this poor man? Let him have some dignity. Mm-hmm. Michael Jackson rubbing off on him is not necessarily the phrase that I would want to use, because that probably... yeah, that probably has a different connotation than what most people would think.
Yeah.
So that was the last time I felt embarrassed by something like that. But anyway, yeah, this is
so
this is something.
It is indeed a thing.
Now let's keep in mind Corey Feldman is big on Halloween. He's played a lot of roles in Halloween themed movies.
Yes.
The Lost Boys and the two forgettable sequels.
Yes.
Friday the 13th, the final chapter.
Mm-hmm.
He's Gremlins.
He stabbed a macheted Jason's face like a billion times.
And had Tommy, no effect.
Tommy something.
It's like wrestling. He no sold it.
Yes.
I have to ask Donnie Mercury about that no selling thing.
He had the two Goonies, matches yesterday, by the way.
Two matches.
Two.
Work. Did he get paid twice? No.
He actually got paid once, though.
He did.
That is his first professional. He can now call himself a professional wrestler because he got paid.
Good for him. Good for him. Bordello of Blood.
Yep.
Wasn't that a George Clooney thing or Quentin Tarantino? I forget who did that one.
That was
or is it Guillermo del Toro or one of those things? I'd have to go and look at it. I remember the name of it.
Greb.
No, don't bring that back, please.
Bring that party back.
Don't bring that back either.
Anybody who dares.
Is this the
that's the previous one. I'll send that to you so you can watch it later.
Yeah, I was actually going to look for that while you were playing
God,
this one.
It's horrible. I'll send it to you. So you'll be muted.
This is Corey Feldman with JRD with their collaboration called Here Comes Halloween.
My apologies to all of you.
Who is it? Whoa! Who is that? Oh, it's JRD. What's up, buddy? You got me. Hey, you ready for the session?
Yeah.
Let's go do it. Come on, up to the studio. Let's go.
All right. Ready to record.
Well,
let's do this. Oh, look, here's your mom. She's got your headphones.
Jordan, here. Wow, are you excited? Mm-hmm. Gotcha, buddy.
Let's do this.
Zombies, vampires, hope you're prepared. Streams, candies, bats, and skin.
Okay, that's over now.
Sad thing is, it is going to, because of the star power behind it, it is going to be an earworm for a lot of people when it's released. And yeah, it's like the line from Jurassic Park. You're more concerned about whether you could. You didn't stop and think about whether you should. It's a thing. The kid had fun.
Yes.
Can't.
What I want to know, watching the video, is JRD comes to the door, but his mom's already inside.
That's just bad editing. Maybe that's what he was going to the door to look for.
Maybe.
You see my mom? You see my mom? Talk about my mom. Yep. No, we're not going to.
No,
we're not going to talk about Kate that way.
No, we are not.
It's just a funny thing. I don't think it's worth that, especially for all the perks that you get for it, like being able to. Well,
no, the JRD has the star power. It's Flavor Flav and Kate Gamble's son.
Yes. Anybody who's got, and Flavor Flav, Flav's got a problem.
Is it Corey Feldman hanging around with his son?
No, it's this Taylor Swift obsession that he's got.
That's what happens when you get sober. You need to cling on to something else.
I'd rather be drunk. But you know, I shouldn't say that. I should never make fun of anybody's sobriety.
No,
but if. You know, whatever gets you through, I guess. One day at a time. If listening to Taylor Swift is what keeps him on the straight and narrow, then by all means,
listen
buy
to all the albums.
Buy all the albums you want. Put more money in her pockets as long as it keeps you on the right path.
Yeah. What you do is you go buy the old albums and you put money in Scooter's pocket, but you still get the same effect for you.
I would rather put money in her pocket than his. Yes. He's a scumbag.
Yes, he is.
So that's neither here nor there. That is Hip Hop Headlines for episode 509. Roman numeral DIX, which is appropriate considering who's hosting the show. We're going to take our first break of the day. And when we come back, we're going to have a little bit of woo news. And then we're going to get into some music on Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 509. With your friends, Minister Jamie and
Billy Booty O'Brien.
More from this nonsense after the break.
Hello, hello. What's your only girl? You're all I think about. You're the only girl for me. You're all I think about. You're special. No, I love you. No, I love you.
Hi, this is Michelle Lake, and you're listening to Mr. Throwback Thursday.
One, two. What's good, yo? This is Ghostface straight from Staten Island, New York. And right about now, it's time for Woo News with Jamie and Bill. Y'all know what it is. Get it correct. Mr. Throwback Thursdays, Jamie and Bill. You know what I mean? On Woo News. That's what's going down right now. Y'all check this out. Exclusive. Peace.
The RZA. The GZA. Raekwon. Master Killer. Inspector Deck, You God, Method Man, Ghostface Killer, an old dirty bastard.
It's now time for Woo News with Mr. Throwback Thursday.
Jimmy, shimmy, y'all. Welcome back, Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 509.
I believe you're actually obligated to come in and say, hey.
No. No, I've said a lot of things on this show. Not doing Michelle A. Not happening. Welcome back, Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 509. It is indeed time for Woo News. We have two pieces of Woo News this week before we get into some music. First piece, Consequence of Sound. Consequence.net is the source. Bobby Digital. And I actually have this record, the 25th anniversary of RZA's solo debut. Mm-hmm. And we don't mean, you know, we love you, Raheem. Oh, God.
Raheem. Oh, that was a different one.
That was Chukwan. I said that to him. He laughed at it later on in the week. 25th anniversary of RZA's solo debut, Bobby Digital in Stereo.
Yes.
Which and, has a.
If you run over to Super 7, you can get the Bobby Digital action figure. The reaction figure.
Reaction figure, yes. different sounding record than the Wu-Tang stuff, man.
Yeah.
But it's 25th anniversary. There is a Bobby Digital reaction figure box set now.
Ooh, a box
from Super 7, as you said. It's a 3.75-inch scale physical form of Bobby Digital from the album cover.
Yes. Sarah is immediately interested now.
The box set includes the Bobby Digital figure with 5 points of articulation and a glossy metallic finish, complete with the Wu-Tang symbol on the chest and a scaled replica of the weapon seen on the LP jacket. Also in the slick metallic and green package is a 45 RPM 7-inch featuring RZA's B-O-B-B-Y and Holocaust, subtitled Silkworm singles, as well as a 45 record adapter that doubles as a stand for the action figure.
That's the coolest thing, because the reaction figures, it's kind of like trying to stand up a G.I. Joe. Mm-hmm. You know, they're very, very wobbly, very unstable.
Yeah.
So to have something to put the foot in, you know, aside from Yo-Yo's cooking, it's a definite bonus. That's why all my Czarface reaction figures are still in the packaging, not because I'm super collector, right, and because I can't stand them up.
So this thing is available. They were giving away three of them. I'm sure they're probably already gone.
Probably.
But
since cool our news thing, has been delayed,
if you are a RZA fan,
no,
like
if you are a Bobby Digital fan,
or a Bobby Digital fan, I should say, yes, I do have the, like I said, I have that album and I found it in the thrift store one day. I had it on CD, and then I was like, this is completely different, man.
So hold on. I haven't been able to do this in like 100 years. Is it this one? Hold on. And here.
Let us begin. What, where, why, or when? How many MCs must get this before somebody says don't be Chris? Why would you ask me a question knowing you knew the answer?
From the posse.
A question from the posse. We haven't played that in years.
We have not. Like I said, nobody wants to ask us anything anymore.
And because we're in Woo News, we got a question from the posse in the chat. Coach Juan, Ron Johansson, with Jamie just wondering if you know if Banks and Steels are doing anything new. That is my Woo question. So I will turn it over to you because I have no idea. I haven't heard anything new from them in a while.
No, it's been like 6 years since they dropped anything. And I think the last thing they did was Anything But Words. And that was a long time ago. No, I have not heard anything. I don't know if what's the, Paul Banks, Interpol. Is that his band?
Yes, I think so.
I don't know if Interpol's doing anything anymore, and that's what's keeping Banks over there. I know Wu-Tang's been touring, so I don't know if that's slowing them down. I don't know. So to answer your question, I don't know, man. But no, I will actively try to find out and see if there's any word on the wire. Maybe we can talk to Cool Kim, who can talk to Shaquan, who can talk to RZA.
Shaquan.
Talk about his hat. No, I'll put feelers out and see if I can find anything out. Who knows?
Excellent question.
Yes.
We do like Banks and Steel stuff, so that'd be something very interested to find out ourselves. Second article of Woo News.
Yes, John, I do remember that. That's what I was hoping it would come out with those for the reaction figures.
Cinema rules everything around me.
Cream.
Go of to course, the movies. They
say, oh.
Global grind. Clips rule everything around me. Hip-hop legend RZA is named the official ambassador of the 2023 Urban World International Film Festival.
Is that pronounced like pizza?
No, that would be pizza. Although I have heard people say pizza.
Yes.
I'm going to have some pizza. We used to say that all the time.
Yes, we did. I never in my life has said, I'm going to get some za.
No. The 27th annual Urban World Film Festival has announced that Grammy and Emmy nominated producer, actor, musician, filmmaker, The RZA,
yes,
will serve as the official ambassador of this year's festival. So he says, I'm completely honored to be a part of the platform like Urban World, which supports storytellers from all walks of life. As a filmmaker, I understand the work that goes into not only getting a film made, but getting it seen. There aren't a lot of film festivals that intentionally shine light on the works of Black men and women in our industry. Our growing number of directors and producers need more outlets. Urban World gets it. And this opportunity to serve as ambassador to this year's festival is an honor and a privilege. So the festival's opening night film will be the Toronto International Film Festival award winner, American Fiction, directed by Cord Jefferson. This festival is going to take place this week, actually, November 1st through 5th at AMC 34th Street in the SVA Theater. HBO will be one of the founding partners. They're returning for their 27th year. Tickets and passes for this festival can be purchased at urbanworld.org if you are interested in attending. Maybe you'll get a chance to meet the RZA. So congratulations to him for being named this year's ambassador to the Urban World Film Festival. It is time for music. Music we did not get to last week because
we were busy.
We were busy discovering the brand new superhero.
Billy Booty Hole Brown.
Which we said we were going to turn into Billy Booty Hole Brown Hornet.
Yes. But,
so let's get into some music, shall we?
Or Guillermo. I'm not sure yet.
Guillermo Greb. Grumpy Hole Greb. That's what it was. Our one and done for episode 509. That would be the Dicks episode, by the way. I believe is a true one and done because I see nothing else by this group.
I didn't see anything either.
Came out in 1999.
A number.
It is from the group Comprehension, and it is Shades of Black.
I think that's backwards.
It's backwards. Yes, they have it backwards on my thing. Shades of Black is the crew.
Yes.
And Comprehension is the record.
Yes.
Well, this tells you how bad the record is when they get the things backwards.
We don't even know who they are either.
On my list. They have artist Comprehension, title Shades of Black. So
yes, that is indeed backwards.
I will send them a little note here. You need to fix this. Shades of Black by Comprehension.
S-O-B,
this
is Shades of.
Ove, yes. I have, they don't even number the tracks on here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 tracks.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 tracks.
Oh. But DJ Introduction is going to like it because track number one is Intro / Comprehension Remix.
Warning. Because they got friends foreign.
Yeah, apparently there's a warning. Track number two, As Long As I.
Shades of Black, New Crops, Cloak and Dagger, DBS, Franchise. Yeah, questioning many incidents where accident or fame, different cases, places, times, and dates. This music's been my escape since as long as I recollect. Problems faced with, for better, for worse. Sickness or good health. Convince somebody else or someone else, but not yourself. So once again, I'm looking in. Temptation to take and begin. Caught up in the action. Trafficking. Cause it catches it, man. It hurts when the spirit convicts you with sin. You think I'm looking through bars. How the game's got me locked in. Too often I've been forced to throw caution to the wind. Measures my.
Track number 3, Light Through Darkness.
We get together for a minute, focus an eye and realize we all deep in it. A lack of control, grip with no hold, and forgetting to know only the soul is infinite. I chose not to fight, that gives me time to find what symbolizes the light. I know the difference between darkness and night. I know the difference darkness between and darkness night. And night.
So what's left? It seems like this world is at its rest, like a last man.
Track number 4, an interlude called Interlude.
Yo, what up, y'all? What's going on? This is Scotch and Orthodox, representing Shades of Black, you know, hip-hop to the fullest. You know, we've been living this, celebrating the culture for a long time now. You know, we just want to give our thanks and show some appreciation. You know, b-boys, graph artists, turntableists, MCs across the planet. This one's for you. It's the Shades.
This one's for you.
Track number 5, Visions. I have those from time to time when I don't sleep enough.
Open up your mental so I insert these lyricals, which produce the inner visions towards the visual. Open up your mental so we insert these lyricals, which produce the inner visions towards the visual. So we insert these lyricals, which produce the inner visions towards the visual. Open up your mental so we insert these lyricals, which produce the inner visions towards the visual.
All up in this, famous, thought you knew this. We spark and ignite niggas forming arson units. After each rhyme, blueprints we design, keep clones for multiply. Change we upgrade to modify. Y'all niggas watered down, stay lacing.
Track number 6, Think It Through. It's always good advice.
Think about it.
Would you join the Navy?
We on some next
like
time.
Like the gravy and rice?
Don't mess with this. We on some next time.
I wouldn't recommend it.
Christian murder. You think you want to run for your
ideas? I'll tell you to think about it.
Cool like it dissed. When we rock like this, whole crews get blitzed. Intro is this, merciless, Mr. Chris. With the marvelous and the ill lyricist. Different shades rocking for the original nation. Curse of whack fools like my forefathers.
Track number 7. True Lies.
Isn't that an Arnold Schwarzenegger movie?
It was, with Jamie Lee Curtis.
And Tom Arnold.
He was actually very good in that movie.
Mm-hmm.
You live true lies.
True lies, you lying to us.
You lying to self.
Flying cause you dying to bust.
You're hating on us.
I see you waiting.
Pray if we bust.
You're on your own.
To make it happen. Stop waiting on us. We done see you. We done see through. Thing to try to. Do too. Me versus you. I see the blue through.
Track number 8. Big Chat.
Not Le Chat.
Not Le Chat.
A lot of raps talk shit when they move in their clicks. But in the middle of a water term, bitch, when I spit. My verbal sent to hit you. My first hug is your brain to shoot. First thought, switch them, then teach them. Pull sun to the side, yo, your time soon come. So you move last year, you bump last year. Might be hot where you come from, but you gon' freeze here. Little bastard got brave, like he the angel of death. Talking big shit, how we gon' put tools in my chest?
Last track on the record, track number 9, Status Climbers, and it's a remix.
Ooh.
I don't know what the first one sounded like.
Just a reminder, where's your girl at?
When
your
grandfather
joining the new line of status climbers.
Yeah,
in the corner, living on the knees, begging for the key, making babies for the G's. I could unfold you if I talked about how I molded you, sculpted you. And you know it's just the way you infiltrated, the way you desecrated, the way you moved with no hesitation throughout the industry. Yo, I saw you on your rise. I saw you status climb.
it just wasn't like that. Bad. It was just, it was kind of there.
Yeah.
There were some parts of it that sounded like it had a lot of potential, but I can see why they were a one and done. Yeah, it was another Columbia. One of those. It was one of those, like we've said in the past, that sounded a lot like everything else from that era, mm-hmm. and didn't really have anything to stand out. It wasn't terrible.
No,
it wasn't great.
I'd say it's a very good background record.
Mm-hmm.
So while you're doing other stuff, just put it on and it yeah. sounds good, but
yeah,
it's nothing that,
but it's not anything I would do a deep dive into.
No, you're not running out looking to see if they have more records.
Beats were good. Beats yeah. were good. I enjoyed it. So Shades of Black with Comprehension was your one and done for episode 509, and only 9 tracks on the thing, so it went yeah. really, really quick.
It was okay.
This week's record of the week, oddly enough, is going to be by your brand new
look at that.
Artist of the month. Thanks to Fly Guy Cool Kim.
Yes.
This week, this month's Artist of the Month for November of 2023 is the UMCs. This is the second album by the UMCs,
which is very different
from the first one.
Yes. From Fruits of Nature. Yeah, which is the one that everybody knows.
Mm-hmm. This one came out January 25th, 1994.
A number.
Running 58 minutes and 21 seconds long on Wild Pitch and EMI Records. This is Unleashed, the second album by Artist of the Month, the UMCs, consisting of Cool Kim and Haas G.
Mm-hmm.
I have 14 tracks on this record.
As do I.
Track number one, Time to Set It Straight.
So, ladies scream and shout, brother work it out, bo. Static, bo, bo, bo. I blow hard like the wind, then I spin your topsy-turvy, I serve you, here's a fruity homage for your scurvy, got my own lucky charm in the middle of my pants, wanna dance high, wind up and boulder on that ass, yo, Rico, I'm slobbing. Here's
a fruity orange for your scurvy.
Which is, you know, a treatment for that sort of thing.
It does come across already right off the jump as a Dos Effects feel. You know, not so much the, you know, as Dos Effects called it, the Iggy Suicide. Not so much, but the delivery minus that.
Right. Track number two, We Go.
I will say, you know, I said they sounded like Dos Effects. I really do like this album. This mm-hmm. this is one of the few artists who can have such different sounding styles on two different albums, and I like both of them.
Yes.
You know, it's not like when Hammer tried to do the funky Headhunter.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't like the change of the way Hammer was trying to represent himself. This seems more like a, hey, we were more teenagers here. We're growing up now.
Yeah. More of an extension of who they are as opposed to, you know, completely, I'm going to try something different.
Yeah.
That doesn't always work.
No.
Track number three, Evil Ways.
The apocalypse, I rips the rhythm, I'm rough and tough to hell, spawn lyricist. Dr. Jekyll, Mr. High Complex. I be a schizo, so I don't know what's next. Here comes the voodoo hex. I rock your whole beat, this smash your world apart, then punch a hole in your chest. To prove you got no heart, I be the arcane master. Mysticist, lyricist, push him over.
Track number, what are we up to? Four.
We are.
Hit the track. So I guess if we're up to four, we better hit the track. So
yes,
we
can
hit the track. Track number five, What's Up?
All the bum alibis.
Track number six, Staten Island Comes First. Mm-hmm.
Baby mama. We got a baby number bubba bubba for you, baby.
For representing Staten Island, we got the mighty UMCs in the house.
Cool Kim in the house.
Hot C's in the house.
So if you're with me,
yeah.
Well, if you're with me,
yeah. Can I get a count on?
You got it, baby mama.
Track number seven, Ill Demonic Click.
Look out.
Track number eight, Speak Some Ill Thoughts.
Chauvinistic, sexist, leaves back my best characteristic. I'm a pathological liar. My father don't trust me. Shit, if I were you, I'd bust me. Cause even I disgust me. Got the problem with my hormones and it's driving me nuts. I like sex with sluts, but they hate my guts. I got the worst luck of all and I can't hold on.
Track number nine. Whoa, now. Track number 10, Pleasure in the Dark.
Okay, player.
That just sounds dirty.
Here we go now.
Whether you're rapping, acting that clever, I'm bad to the bone. That's what's up, whenever, whatever, cause I'm just cool, Kim. Hey, yo, I'm only cool, Kim. Turn off the lights and me and you can make it. This sort of go kinda psycho, wearing bunches like my forefathers did. It's me and you against the world, Hoss. So is your with me, kid?
Well, if you didn't know, Hoss whips when I lash, dash like flash, and I'm right behind.
Yeah, this is a completely different record from Fruits of Nature, but it is good.
Oh, no, it's a really good record.
It's solid. It is a solid record. Track number 11, Can You Feel It?
I'm coolin', I kick the large shot to the motherfucking Wu Clan. Here goes the rules and follow cause I'll knock her. Pump to the land of the lost like Chaka. I'm sorta like the sleep stack, so flee black. My shit is never whack gum.
Alright, it's my favorite track on the record just for the Land of the Lost reference. Track number 12. That's just how it's gotta be. So track number 12, How It Gotta Be.
Okay.
I'm the motherfucker, master of charisma. I got some shit to give you, I deliver. Hits that make you quiver, go ooh for the tactic. Girl, you knew I had it, it's emphatic.
So track number 12 was How It Gotta Be. Track number 13, I guess the answer is sure.
It sounds that way.
Because track number 12 or 13 is Gotta Be Sure. How It Gotta Be?
Gotta be sure.
I slip into your pants, I make a jump to your feet. I wanna rock with you, dig it. On the good foot, I tripped, I get a grip by the lip, and then bump you with the hip, then I split like a bit.
And finally, track number 14, last track on the record, My Thing.
Pick a fight on the mic. If your rap don't sound right, I keep on rolling, 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 rolling down the river. Make you shiver, quiver to the rhyme I deliver. On my track, my rap knack can never call it slack. I kick your spine out your back. If you try and say I'm like, I be the rap playboy,
a hip hop,
Huey Hefner, a real sexy MF-er,
like Prince,
but much deffer. You're just a rap rapper.
A real sexy MF-er like Prince.
That is your record of the week by your artist of the month, the UMCs. This was Unleashed. I do have a little bit of charting action on this.
Do you?
I do indeed. No singles, but the album itself did chart on the U.S. Heat Seekers albums on Billboard, peaking at 22, and the top R&B hip hop albums at number 63 for Unleashed by the UMCs, your record of the week for episode 509. That comes on the heels of your one and done Shades of Black with Comprehension. Remind you that the artist of the month is UMCs, at least starting on the first.
Yes.
Until then, for the first 2 days of this week, while you're listening, it's still Tupac. So you got 2 days to listen to Tupac.
You get a twofer.
And then switch over to UMCs. Before we take our final break, we have an old to the new.
We do.
And this is DJ Eddie F, Heavy D's DJ.
Yes.
Along with Eric Sermon. Featuring Jaron Benton. And the name of the record is This Is Hip Hop.
Eric Sermon. DJ Eddie F. Jared Spencer.
Hey, yo, Redman hit me on the phone last night, all the way from Europe to tell me I was tight. On the mic, I'm agua, think no difference. I'm born with the gift shit, some of y'all addicted. So who you gonna blame it on, Jamie? Stop it. You see these wax officers won't cop it. Hip-hop's my baby, you wanna adopt it. But you ain't fit for this, for me, so drop it. The number one topic, E, I'm that nigga. Cat follow me like if I was on Twitter. Plus, Eric B on the cut like scissor. I'm sharp like the hand on Wolverine or RZA. Nigga, some acts, will I give it up? Maybe.
No.
If the rap game wasn't so crazy. If the rap game wasn't so lazy. If everybody's vision wasn't hazy. Back then, I could have been the boss. I could have had 50. I could have had Biggie. I could have had Luda. I could have had Game. I could have had Wu-Tang. I could have had Ross. But I'm a kid of smoke that's in the air. And if you can't see me, homie, I spark a flare. Wherever hip hop is playing that, I'm near. Yeah, hands in the air like, yeah.
We in this bitch like, yeah. New York down to the A like, yeah. If you're getting money and you fly, say, yeah. Girls getting wild in this bitch like, yeah.
Yeah, we gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah,
we gon' do it.
Stop the press, who the heck is that? Elude the beat, I'm finna rape the track. This is my house, these niggas they hate that. Pull fair moves, you fuckin' fade to black. And the flow just flames and kerosene. And these bitches wanna hang like David Carradine. J2 fly, could blaze these pair of wings. Taking fat whores out for treats and Dairy Queen. Yeah, I'm very clean. New Chuck Taylors. Outfit tailored on my way to the cater. Life got a funny way of saying fuck you. Got a fuck to my name in the freaking rent suit. You couldn't fathom the shit we've been through. So I don't give a fuck if we offend you. It's hard when you work in these lame 9 to 5s. In the meanwhile, trying to keep him. Hop a lot, backpackers, Jay's back at it. Grandma stressed, her son's a crack addict. And he keeps swiping 20s on my auntie's purse. And he's stooping in the room when she on the way to church. Damn, waiting is worse. And I try to play hard like the shit don't hurt. This that hardcore death squad raised on the tongue shit. But it gets thumped if a nigga say the wrong shit. Think we got a problem, Houston. No telling what type of drugs I'm using. Yeah, this is hip hop, stupid, and we ain't dumbing down for you niggas' amusement.
Jared Spencer.
We in this bitch like, yeah. New York down to the A like, yeah. If you're getting money and you fly, say, yeah. Girls getting wild in this bitch like, yeah.
Yeah, we gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah,
we gon' do it. Yeah, we gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah, this is hip hop,
yeah,
stupid.
We gon' do it.
Yeah.
This is Hip Hop, brought to you by DJ Eddie F, along with Eric Sermon, featuring Jaron Benton. You're old to the new for episode 509. That just had such a classic feel.
Yes.
Celebrating the 50th anniversary. And Eric Sermon could wrap the phone book and I would be enthralled,
yes,
with it. So I hope you all enjoyed that. We're going to take our final break of the day. I'm going to read some lyrics. Maybe we'll touch on foosball. Maybe not. Depends on what we decide
Who
to
knows?
Do. But I will definitely read some lyrics on Mr. Throwback Thursday, brought to you by the law offices of WMWESQ, the hip hop hockey injury law firm. Do that hockey so
we can all get paid.
Coming right back after the break.
Peace and blessings. MC Globe, GLOBE for the NYC. Hollering at the Throwback Thursday team. Yes.
But it starts with Bill.
I'm Bill S. Preston.
It's called reading. Top to bottom, left to right. Group words together as a sentence. Take Tylenol for any headaches. Might offer any cramps.
Most people probably don't listen to the lyrics, but they should.
Welcome to Bill Reads Lyrics.
Welcome back, Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 509. It is indeed time for Bill Reads Lyrics. So, I'm almost afraid, like I always am at this time. Here we are.
We are here. You know it.
You know.
So, we're gonna.
I am so afraid.
We're gonna do verse
if
one.
If you're laughing this much before you even send it to me,
it's not so much what I'm laughing. It's why I'm laughing. It has nothing to do with the actual lyrics. It's where the lyrics came from.
I'll tell you why I'm laughing, honey. Because I ain't shit.
Yeah.
My name, real name,
Leroy.
Leroy. I work at the car wash.
All right.
I stole that car.
I'm going to send this over to you.
Okay, let's see.
You're going to do verse one in the chorus, and there's a reason, and we'll find out in just a moment, because with no type of ado, Sesame Street Grover style, whether nearer or further, we will cue the motherfucking piano.
I'm out of town, thuggin' with my rounds. My coochie pink, my booty hole brown. Where are the Nickelbacks? I'm looking for the hoes. Quit playing Nickelback. Come suck a bitch toe. Pound Town. Just left Pound Town with my Nickelback. He just took a bitch down. Yeah, that Nickelback dick, a bitch down. Yeah, that Nickelback eat me out. Pound Town. Just left Pound Town with my Nickelback. He just took a bitch down. Yeah. That Nickelback dick a bitch down. Yeah. That Nickelback eat me out.
Billy Booty Old Brown.
Yeah.
Never ever will that artist appear on the show again.
No, but I'm not surprised.
But there was a particular line in there that needed to be played.
Yes. And I hope I did it justice when I got to it. Last reminder for anybody who has not put the hashtag into the chat. We are going to be giving away the cookies in just a moment. These are the coolest cookies in the universe.
They are.
Because Darlie made them.
Yes, yes, she did.
if you order them, they
messaged Preem. Carol. I messaged Preem because he posted that he got some, and I said, "Did yours also come from Darlie Makes Cookies?" He said, "Yes, they did."
Yes, they did. Who the fuck is Darlie?
I don't know, but she makes some cookies.
All right, I've given everybody ample time. How many people are in the drawing?
That's a very good question. Looks like Fife
dog.
Yes, Fife entries. So let's draw and see who's going to win some of Daryl Makes Cookies. Ronnie J,
who gave us the question from the posse today. Yes. So
now he gets some Darlie made cookies from Daryl Makes Cookies. And you should go get some of these, and they're at dmc-cookies.com.
So congratulations, Ron. Enjoy your Daryl made cookies.
Yes. Ronnie, hit me up. I think I have your address somewhere, but hit me up with your address, and I will put these in the Merle.
How are we doing time-wise? Do we have time to touch on a certain sporting event?
If you can keep it under about 5 minutes.
Yeah, I think we can run through it real quick. We'll just go through what the records are.
And the standings, not so much the.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Well, let's do a little bit of this.
Foosball. Bunch of overgrown monsters manhandle each other.
Hello. you play to win the game.
Playoffs? I'm talking about playoffs? You kidding me? Playoffs? I just hope we can win a game.
Let's quickly go to the league. The league.
Yes, but you should be watching.
We are on week 8. Coming into this week, number one team in the league, at 6-1. And the bottom team in the league at number 12 is the Ahmad Sauce Committee Part 2 at 2-5. I, at one point, was really high, and now I'm really, really low. So this week's matchup is for me. Let's see. Where is the league matchups here?
Oh, you are a hot mess.
Well, I'm not used to looking at it on my phone. That's why.
This week, you play against Belichick yourself.
Yeah.
3-4 in 10th place. You 2-5 in 11th place. I 3-4 in 8th place and playing John Protect Kirk's Neck, who is 4-3 in 4th place.
Ugh. I just found out my father-in-law's cat is not good. He needs to have two teeth removed, and just, you know, my father-in-law can't deal with a whole lot of depression right now because he's been through a lot. So I don't know why this password just all of a sudden changed, because it's not even on my other one.
I do not know.
Let's see. Email a code. Verify with Google account. Let's do it that way. And then I should be able to get back in here. So remind me later to resolve. Oh, okay. Now I'm in. Yay. That's so stupid. I had to connect it through Google in order to get to the
Stranger
fantasy.
Things have happened.
It could be worse. So anyway, yes. Hey, look at that. There's the real page that I look at every week. So yes, I am taking on Belichick yourself. That is a matchup of the 11th and 10th place teams in the league.
Yep.
You, Breece Hall Hotel, at 3-4, taking on John Protect Kirk's Neck. You're at 3-4, 8th in the league. John is 4-3, 4th in the league.
Yes.
Ahmad Sauce Committee Part 2, Ian, 2-5, 12th in the league, taking on MC Aiden featuring DMW. That is Sanket. He is at 4-3, 3rd in the league. That's pretty sad when the 3rd and 4th place teams in the league are one game over 500. Either that or it's really good, because a lot of parity. Arrested to Belichick. I'm not taking on Dr. Tim. I'm taking on Becca.
Yeah.
Arrested to Belichick. Dr. Tim. The two Belichicks fuck me up every week. 3-4 at 7th place, taking on Gangrene Hoodie with the Woody, who is our contest winner this week, Ron EJ. Mm-hmm. 5-2 in 2nd place. Put it in, Friar Mouth. 3-4 at 9th in the league, taking on you, Kelsey. What I, Kelsey, at 6-1. First in the league. And then Revenge on Lazard City at 3-4, taking on Felicia Young and Entertaining at 4-3. So that's 6-5. Very close league this year.
Yeah.
The worst record in the league is 2-5, which is me and Ian together. I think I'm still the second highest scoring person now since I've been passed. But that's because I ran up a shit ton of score early in the year.
Yeah.
But then I've run into injury issues and things like that. But you know, it is what it is. Stupid me did not have Mr. Kincaid playing on Thursday night because I was not expecting him. Now I find out that Dawson Knox is on the DL for the year, or at least for 6 weeks. So he's going to be my tight end moving forward. But let's hope that Mr. Njoku out in Cleveland can.
Yes, I believe he will have a good game.
Yes.
He will not have a good game as Mr. Kincaid. But, you know.
No. And I got to get a new running back too, because Latavius Murray isn't doing shit for me. But anyway, that's where we stand. It's a very competitive league.
It is. Just sucks except for Greg. A possibility. Who knows?
That's more than likely the truth. I'm a wiener. Well, I'm a lawyer.
Indeed.
I got a mug that says so. So that is your foosball update.
So I believe it is time for you to switch from Bill, Booty Hole Bill, to Phil,
Booty Hole Bill. No, I will switch from Billy Booty Hole Ground to Guillermo Rumpy Hole.
Well, you do that.
But that doesn't take us home. So I will go from Bill to Phil.
But you should please take us home.
Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 509, brought to you in part by WMW ESQ. No, it's so terrible.
And Darlie makes cookies.
And Darlie makes cookies, yes. Otherwise, brought to you by our usual cast of sponsors, the World's Strongest Coffee, Deathwish Coffee. Find them on Facebook, X, Instagram, and deathwishcoffee.com. Use the code TBT and Tiki Taki. Save the code TBT to save 12% off your first order at Deathwish Coffee. Def Rugs, defrugs.com, Facebook, X, and Instagram, all at Def Rugs. Handmade, high-quality hip-hop themed rugs from the original Rug E Fresh. Marshall Fox and his business associate, who brought you the old to the new this week, or at least part of it anyway, yes. Eric Sermon. Go check out Def Rugs and order yourself a Def Rug. Up in Schenectady, New York, as the weather gets colder, it's much easier to order. From our good friend Heather Lent on J Street, who is the proprietor of Bittersweet Candy Company up there. She makes coffee and coffee. She makes, well, coffee themed stuff. Sure. Too. She makes coffee flavored stuff, I think. But she makes candy and chocolate. That's what I was going for. That is handmade, small batch, different and
delicious.
Check them out on Facebook and order at bittersweetcandy.com. Use our code throwback to save 10% off your order at Bittersweet Candy. Melted Mics, MLTDMICS.com. Hip hop themed t-shirts like Jamie's Crumbs t-shirt he was wearing last week. You can get other t-shirts like that at meltedmics.com. Use MR Throwback Thursday as your promo code and you'll save 10% off your order there.
You cannot get a Billy Booty Hole Brown shirt made there Etsy, yet.
Not yet. Who knows though? Etsy.com/shop/geeklikeyou, where the geek shall inherit the earth.
Yes.
Brought to you by the sick twisted mind of Mr. Throwback Thursday and a sick twisted wife, Mrs. Throwback Thursday. Hip hop and pop culture items. And are they? They're not in the Etsy shop, are they?
No.
So but those are available as well. If you go to MrThrowbackThursday.com, we have 7 of our Good Day Bowls left as of right now. So
get them before they're gone.
Anyway, social media network for the show, MrThrowbackThursday.com, the homepage for everything. You can check out the show notes. You can check out all the cool stuff we have. You can leave us voicemail messages through the Hit Us Up app, and we will play them on the air.
And who knows, there may be a Billy Booty Hole Brown shirt on there sooner or later.
If you want to leave your best Cool Kim impression saying Billy Booty Hole Brown, we invite you to go to Mr. Throwback Thursday and hit us up, and I'll just get inundated with Billy Booty Hole Brown for the remainder of my life. As well as the webpage, we have our social medias. On X, we are at the MR, the underscore MR underscore TBT, and Bill underscore MR underscore TBT, which is also my Instagram and Threads handle. Jamie on Instagram and Threads is MR Throwback Thursday. If you are a purveyor of the Tiki Talk, I believe it is under MR Throwback Thursday too.
I think so, yeah.
Just search Mr. Throwback Thursday, you'll find it. And there is one that's marked Bill Reads Lyrics. I was going to do that, but every time we put up anything like that, it's just going to be,
it goes away.
It'll go away because apparently you can't swear on TikTok.
Yeah. Well, you can't say things like booty hole.
Yeah. So we're not going to do a Bill Reads Lyrics TikTok page. I wish we could, but TikTok is weird. So we're not going to do that. We also have an email address, mrthrowbackthursday@gmail.com. If you want to send Jamie pieces of information, like I did yesterday,
yeah,
which may end up in the show next week just for the severity of it. But
fucking lunatic,
he is a nut job. And you can also check us out every Thursday morning at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Fresh Radio at itsfreshradio.com and the Fresh Radio app for your phone. Brought to you by DJB, the hardest working turntablist in the world. We are on right after the All Request show. Yes. Shout outs.
Yay, yay.
Gail Dunmire, Manny Baez, Sarah Henderson, John Henderson, Hugo Gonzalez, Sanket Patel, Teresa Lynn's Simple Luxuries at TeresaLynn's.com. Clay Arsenault, the Shrieking Warrior, Jennifer Buchanan, Jason Heath, Jessica Walker, Shane Hatley, Ricky Schnarr, Kenneth Elsfelder, Mr. Cranky Pants, Brian Hollenbeck, who was threatening to revoke his patronage after what we played earlier. The legend, Kevin Van Buren, Robert Jeffroy, Kate Harvey, Catherine Liska, and Ken Dwinell. They get mentioned every week because I got five
on it. Or more.
You want to get your name mentioned every week? Become a patron. Go to patreon.com/MRTBT. And that'll get you on the good list.
It will.
Don't forget, as always, check out our friends in the industry, the Kings of Sport, Brother Nate Milton, Chris Ely over at the Kings of Sport, Anthony Imran and Rug Boy over at the Jock and Nerd podcast. Talking Ty has a new episode out.
She does.
Season 3, episode 1 of What's the Word podcast with Brooklyn Ty NYC. We mentioned DJB on It's Fresh Radio. Go check that out. Wild One Radio at wildoneradio.com, 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Thursdays and all throughout the weekend on Wild One Radio. Don't forget to subscribe, rate, review, and all of that good
stuff. That is very important.
Your input helps our output. We've been saying it for close to 10 years, and we do mean every word of it. We also want to remind you, you have got to stay hydrated.
Damn straight.
Go find us and share the good word. Take good care of yourselves and each other. Advise your hands to wash themselves.
And then you can wash your butt.
Using those hands, yes. Because your butt does not wash itself. And until next time, keep it classic. And always remember,
new school stale, old school fresh.